my inspiration and get me past this block and walk me through the great unknown. You could be my true salvation. Unchain me from this lock and keep me from being alone. 'Cause I'm no good at being alone. Let me play bigger halls. I will do a river dance as long as you keep answering my calls. Get me out of my apartment. Keep me from my empty walls. Someone hire John McCormick. Start the wearing of the green. Let me win the Irish sweepstakes. Let me take you home, Kathleen. I can be in love with someone. I can be in love with someone. I can be in love with someone.
Professor at Columbia said he had called and, yeah, that's right, Dr. Adler. Well, look, I know it's just a draft, but I really think it's getting to, whatever. Well, look, I don't know if we're agents. Dr. Adler just suggested that I, Well, should I drop that off in person or, okay, I'll put that in the mail then. No, that's great. Thank you. What's your address? Oh, you read it. Great, that's... Thank you so much. That means a lot to me. Yeah, I really am 23. Sure. You know, whenever's convenient. Tuesday, 9 o'clock. Great, I'm there. I'm really looking forward to meeting you, Miss Whitfield. Okay, Linda? No, thank you. Thank you. This is great.
You know what makes me crazy? I'm sorry, can I say this? You know what makes me nuts? The fact that we can be together here, together, sharing our night, spending our time, and you are gonna choose someone else to be with. No, you are. Yes, Jamie, that's exactly what you're doing. You could be here with me or be there with them. As usual, guess what you pick? No, Jamie, you do not have to go to another party, and your book would survive as a point of fact if you stay with your wife on her fucking birthday, and you could, God forbid, even see me act. And I know in your soul it must drive you crazy that you don't get to play with your little girlfriends. No, I'm not, no, I'm not. And the point is, Jamie, you can't spend a single day. That's not about you, and you, and nothing but you. Marvelous, you. Isn't he wonderful? Just 28, the savior of our life. You and nothing but you. Miles and miles of you. Pushing through windows and bursting through walls. On route to the sky. And Ryan, I'm calling I'm interrupting. Well, two things. First, I just wanted to make sure you got those reviews I sent from the summer. Yes, I got some notices in the local paper about Rosalind, and I thought you would enjoy them. Oh, okay, well, I'll send out another set of those, sure. Right, well, the other thing was just, you know, checking in, seeing if there was anything you wanted to send me out for. I feel like I'm in a really good place right now. Yes. Yes, as soon as I'm doing something in the city, I will let you know. Okay, I understand. Thanks for taking the time back. I'll talk to you soon.
I dreamed of riding like the high in my air. Now I'm the subject of a bidding war. I met my personal Aphrodite. I'm doing things I never dreamed of before. We start to take the next step together. Found an apartment on 73rd. Monthly's printing my first chapter. 2,000 bucks worth of rewriting one word. I left Columbia and I don't regret it. I wrote a book and suddenly made a Reddit. My heart's been stolen, my ego's stolen. I just keep rolling along. I'm spinning out of control, out of control. I'm feeling panicked and rushed and hurried. I'm feeling outmaneuvered and outclassed. But I'm so happy I can't get worried about this singular impression. I got a singular impression things are moving too fast.
Jamie Lynn, staring.
a little Christmas story. I call it the story of Shul, Taylor of Klimovich. Merry Christmas. Shul would work till 10:30 at his tailor's shop in Klimovich, get up at dawn and start again with the hems and pins and twist. 41 years had come and gone at his tailor's shop in Klimovich, watching the winter soldier on, there was one thing Shul missed. If I only had time, old Shul said, I would build a dress that's in my head, a dress to fire the mad desire of girls from here to Minsk. But I have no more hours left to sew. And the clock upon the wall began to glow. And the clock said, na 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 na, Shul will get to be happy. Shul said, no, no, it's not my lot. I gotta make do with the time I've got. Shul was done at 10:30, and he said, good night, old Klimovich. He put on his coat to go, but then the clock cried, wait, not yet. Even though you're not wise or rich, you're the finest man in Klimovich. Listen up, Shul, make one switch and you'll see what you can get. But Shul said, clock, it's much too late. I'm at peace with life, I accept my fate. But the clock said, Shul, one switch and you'll unlock the dreams you've lost. So Shul, with reluctance, took his thread. He pulled the bolts of velvet, and he said, I should take all my teeth and for bed. I'm sitting here in talking clocks instead. And the clock said, na 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 na, Shul, you'll get to be happy. Na 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 na, I give you one little time. Na 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 na, just do it and you can be happy. So Shul put the thread through the needle's eye, and the moon stared down from a starry sky. And he pushed the thread through the velvet black, and he looked and the clock was turning back. So he grabbed some shears and he cut some lace, as the hands moved left on the old clock's face. And his fingers flew and the fabric swirled. It was 9:15 all around the world. Every cut and stitch was a perfect fit, as if God himself were controlling it. And Shul cried through a rush of tears, take me back, take me back, oh, 41 years. Down that silent street, till Shul's dress was at last complete. He stretched his arms, and he closed his eyes, and the morning song finally started to rise. And the dress he made on that endless night was a dress that could make any soul take flight. Not a smudge, not a stain had gone to waste, every ribbon and button ideally placed. And sewn into the seams were 41 seasons of dreams. Dreams that you could feel coming. That fairy dress, so the paper swore, was the dress a girl in Odessa wore, on the day she promised forevermore to love a young man named Shmuel, who only one day before had knocked at her kitchen door. Plenty have hoped and dreamed and prayed, but they can't get out of Kalovich. If Shmuel had been a cute Irish maid, he'd have looked a lot like you. Maybe it's just that you're afraid to go out onto a limb of bitch. Maybe your heart's completely swayed, but your head can't follow through. Shouldn't I want the world to see the brilliant girl who inspires me? Don't you think that now's the time to be the ambitious freak you are? Say goodbye to wiping ashtrays at the bar. Say hello to Kathy Ryan, Broadway star. Cause I say, la 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 la, Kathy, you get to be happy. La 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 la, give you unlimited time. La 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 la, stop prepping. Here's a headshot guy in a new backstage where you're right for something on every page. Take a breath, take a step, take a chance. Take your time. I mentioned today how lucky I am to be in love with you.
Rich.
one's Jerry Seinfeld. That one's John Lennon there. No, the Dakota. The San Remo is a few blocks. Have you been inside the museum? We should go. Meet the dinosaurs. Kathy.
I do.
every other woman in the world suddenly finds you attractive. Well, that's not true. It only affects the kind of women you always wanted to sleep with, but they wouldn't give you the time of day before. And now they're banging down your door and falling to their knees. At least that's what it feels like, because you can't not touch them. Next game, look at them. Close your eyes, close your eyes, close your eyes. Except you're sitting there eating your corned beef sandwich. And all of a sudden, this pair of breasts walks by and smiles at you, and you're like, that's not fair. And in a perfect world, a miracle would happen, and every other girl would fly away. And it'd be me and Kathy, and nothing else would matter. But it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. I mean, I'm happy. And it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. It's not a problem, it's just a challenge. It's a challenge to resist temptation. Say that what exacerbates the problem is I got these parties on the center of attention. I'm the grand fromage, and here she comes. Let's get a cup of coffee. Will you look at my manuscript? And I'm showing her my left hand. I'm gesticulating with my left hand, and now there's Kathy. Of course she knows, and they always know. And there's that really awkward moment where I try to show I wasn't encouraging this, but of course I sort of was. And I don't want to look whipped in front of this woman, which is dumb. I should care what she thinks, since I can't fuck her. World, a miracle would happen, and every girl would look like Mr. Ed. And it'd be me and Kathy, and nothing else would matter. But it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. You know I love her. And it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. It's what I wanted, and I'm fine, I'm fine, I'm fine. It's not a problem, it's just a challenge. It's a challenge to resist temptation.
When you come home to me, I'll wear a sweeter smile and hope that for a while you'll stay. When you come home to me, your hand will touch my face and banish any trace. When you come home to me, I'll wear a sweeter smile and hope that for a while you'll... Oh, okay. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Played the piano for years, maybe since the war, but she determined to buy him a piano for his little apartment. And she reasoned that she wouldn't need to buy a very good piano since her father referred to himself as just a saloon player. Maybe a little spinet so he could bang out some Irving Berlin or Cole Porter like he must have in his army days. She saw a classified ad for a small console just refurbished for $300, and that sounded about right to her. She went and looked at the piano, and the owner played her some little classical thing, nothing she recognized, And though she really couldn't tell whether the piano was any good or not, it all seemed to feel right to her. And she gave the man $300 and an extra $50 to deliver it to her father's apartment. She got to his apartment on his birthday, a half hour before the piano was supposed to arrive, and she was unable to concentrate on anything her father said. When the piano finally came, 15 minutes late, but that was fine, her father was overcome with surprise, and a wide smile crossed his face. She helped the man move the piano against the wall, right underneath the picture of her mother. And when her father came over and just ran his thin, pale hands slowly over the wood, lifting and releasing the music rack, twisting the knobs on the lid, tears filled her eyes, and she forgot to give the man a tip when she walked into the door and thanked him. She came to the apartment again 2 months later with a stack of sheet music she had found at a flea market. When she put the music in the piano bench, she looked up and saw that her father had placed photographs of his children and grandchildren on top of the lid. And she realized that he had not lifted the lid to play since the day the piano had arrived. If you didn't know her very well, you would hardly have noticed the clipped replies in her conversation, the mutterings under her breath, the speed with which she finished eating, the force with which she threw her silverware in the sink.
We have 2 minutes where you don't just contradict everything I say. Kathy, please, 2 minutes. And then it is your turn, and you can say whatever you want. There are people, and they are publishing my book, and there's a party that they are throwing. And while you've made it very clear that you're not going, I will be going, and that's done. But what's it really about? Is it really about a party, Kathy? Can we please, for a minute, stop blaming and say what you feel? Is it just that you're disappointed to be going again to Ohio? Did you think this would all be much easier than it's turned out to be? Well then talk to me, Kathy. Talk to me. If I didn't believe in you, we'd never have gotten this far. If I didn't believe in you, and all of the 10,000 women you are, if I didn't think you could do anything you ever wanted to, if I wasn't certain that you'd come through somehow. The fact of the matter is, Kathy, I wouldn't be standing here now. If I didn't believe in you, I'd walk out the door and say, Kathy, you're right. But I never could let that go, knowing the things about you I know. Things when I met you 4 years ago, I knew. It never took much convincing to make me believe. To be happy, Kathy. At some point down the line, don't we get to relax without some new service to push me yet further from you? If I'm cheering on your side, Kathy,
Why can't you support mine? Why do I have to feel I've committed some felony? Doing what I always swore I would do. I don't want you to hurt. I don't want you to sink. But you know what I think? I think you'll be fine. Just hang on and you'll see. But don't make me wait till you do to be happy with you. Will you listen to me? No one can give you courage. No one can thicken your skin. I will not fail so you can be comfortable, Kathy. I will not lose because you can't win. If I didn't believe in you, then here's where the travelogue ends. If I didn't believe in you, I couldn't stood before all of our friends and said, this is the life I choose. This is the thing I can't bear to lose. Trip us or trap us, but we refuse to fall. That's what I thought we agreed on, Kathy. If I hadn't believed in you, wouldn't have loved you at all. Well, why don't you put your dress on and we'll go. Okay? Can we do that, Kathy, please? Please?
You don't have to watch the news. You don't have to learn to tango. should get up, kid. Kathy is waiting. Look at us lying here, dreaming, pretending. I made a promise and I took a vow. I wrote a story and we changed the ending. Kathy, just look at me now. Oh, all right. to know. Since I have to be in love with someone, since I need to be in love with someone, maybe I could be in love with someone like you.
Yeah.
and loved you so.